participating in a minyan, or being yotze, Megillah, Havdallah, and all other means remotely. Is one who prays at home and joins a minyan, or being yotze Megillah, and everything we said, by phone or video call, considered to have prayed with a minyan? Can one complete a minyan in the shul this way, that there are 9 people there, and he's the 10th at home hearing from a video call? May one answer amen upon hearing a bracha over a phone call or a video call, hearing Havdalah, hearing other things. The Shulchan Aruch, Siman Nun Hei, writes that a minyan is only completed if there are at least 10 men grouped in one room. However, in Mishnah Berurah quotes a Prima Gadim, who explains the Shulchan Aruch refers only to the original 10 men needed to complete the minyan. In contrast, one who wishes to take part in the minyan, which already has 10 men in one room, may remain in a different room. Where there is a minyan together, the Shekhinah, Hashem's divine presence, comes down to join them in their prayer. Chachamim tell us, even an iron curtain can't stop one who wishes to join a minyan and Shekhinah in prayer. As long as the minyan is complete, one joining elsewhere, even from a great distance, will be considered as if they prayed with a minyan. At the first glance, it would seem that once a minyan has already been completed, one may join from the outside, even by means of a phone call, a video call. However, there's another issue that arises. The Shulchan Aruch, in the same Siman, Siman Nun Hei, Seif Kaf, writes that if the minyan is saying Kedusha, a passerby may answer amen even though he is not in the room with the minyan. However, the Shulchan Aruch quotes an alternative view that says that if there's garbage or place of idol worshipping that separates between the passerby from the minyan, he may not answer amen to the Kedusha or answer the Kedusha. The Kafachaim notes that the Poskim explained the two opinions do not necessarily argue with each other, even though in the first glance it seems like they argue, but over here they're not. The explanation provided by many authorities is that it's a general rule regarding the Shulchan Aruch quoting of two different and separating opinions. When he quotes an halacha and then he writes an opposing view from the alternative source, we assume normally that the halacha is like the original halacha written. It's called Stam Veshomrim, halacha Kestam, with all the rules that go into it. Why do these opinions understand that we rule like the alternative view written in the Shulchan Aruch in this instance? Perhaps they understand that they don't necessarily argue with the first opinion. The second opinion just comes to explain and add a new idea to the first opinion of the Shulchan Aruch. One may learn that way, that the Shulchan Aruch is explaining in the second opinion and adding to the first. Therefore, because one who joins a minyan remotely will have garbage between themselves, or place of Avodah Zarah worshipping between his location and actual minyan, it would be improper to join the minyan this way. Indeed, the Or Lezion rules that one may not answer amen on the telephone for this very reason. And he calls it an amen yetoma. Still, Chacham Ovadia in Yechaveh Da'at quotes the Vilna Gaon, who rules that as long as one cannot actually see the garbage or place of idol worshipping, that separating between him and the minyan may join in. As such, one on a phone call or a video call will be permitted to join the minyan because the garbage between them and the minyan cannot be seen. There is also another issue with joining a minyan remotely. In addition to not fulfilling one's obligation to pray with a minyan, one is also answering amen to a blessing that they hear from the cantor, from the chazan. The halacha states that any blessing which one is obligated to answer amen and he can't hear the actual bracha, the actual blessing, considered amen yetoma. If one did not hear the blessing being said, yet answered amen, one has uttered an amen yetoma and offered amen. And the Gemara over there writes terrible things to a person that answers amen yetoma. The concept of amen yetoma is discussed over there in the Mishnah Berurah, which he notes the achronim, the rule, that the reciting Chazarat HaShatz is a genuine requirement, and for this reason, one is not permissible to answer amen to a Chazan's blessing if he did not actually hear the blessing. According to his opinion and those opinions, it would not help if one knows which blessing is answering amen to. If he didn't hear it, he can't answer amen to that blessing. In the Biur al-Chayib, he concludes that it is better for one who did not hear every word of the blessing not to answer amen. In other words, amen yetoma has in similarities to answering also and saying brachot levatala. Just like if you have something that's considered a bracha that's doubtful, you would stay away from saying it. Also here in Amen Yatoma, since it's very severe, as we explained before, over here also one should refrain from saying amen that's doubtful. Similarly, Moshe Feinstein writes that one should not answer amen to Kaddish if he did not hear the words from the Chazan, noting that the halakha is the same as the case brought by the Mishnah Berurah above. In addition to the above, there is another issue with answering amen to a bracha heard over the telephone or internet, namely that the amen has no blessing on which to be answered. In Shiurim Metzuyanim LaHalakha, he dwells into the subject of how the voice is transmitted over the phone. The sound that one hears is not the voice of the speaker itself, but rather an analog conversation, and that converts the data which itself was converted from the one who spoke. As such, it is no better than a recording, and has no inherent holiness into it. He concludes that one may not answer amen or make any other responses to blessing or prayer over the telephone. For that reason, he concludes, we can also learn to our halakha as well, that one should not apply Zoom or other forms of internet communications. Harav Shlomo Zalman Orbach writes something similar as well. However, he includes microphone in his prohibition, saying that the sound waves that one hears must have directly came from the source of the sound, which is the voice of the Chazan or one making the blessing. He asserts that this is the halakha, despite the potential surprise of those who might hear his ruling. Another issue with joining a minyan remotely is Chacham Ovadia, Rav Ovadia Yosef, that writes that in a large minyan where people are having trouble hearing the chazan, the cantor, the chazan is still prohibited to use a microphone to project his voice. He argues that where one would not be able to hear the words without the aid of the microphone, it is considered as if they have not heard the words at all. Thus, because one who participates in the minyan remotely cannot hear the cantor without the phone or video, they cannot deem their prayer as if they were with the minyan. Because it is unclear if a blessing heard remotely is halachically considered as the person heard it, one must absolutely refrain from answering amen to such a blessing. In the event that the ruling is that the person did not hear the blessing, the amen would be orphaned, and that is a serious sin. In conclusion, although some halachic authorities permit it, my opinion is that one should not join a minyan remotely. In addition, one who does hear prayers or any other blessing via the phone or video should not answer amen to the blessing they hear to avoid saying amen yetoma and orphaned.